Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be sharing detailed guidelines for all those who are starting with Stage 1 workbook. These guidelines will help you if you are a learner yourself or if you are a parent trying to teach Abacus methods to your child. These guidelines will help you progress through the Stage 1 in a systematic manner to help finish the Stage 1 in a time-bound way and maximize the benefits for yourself. Okay, so let's begin. For all learners, irrespective of age, the concept of Abacus calculations is brand new while at the start of Stage 1. It will begin with identification of numbers on the abacus or how to show different numbers on the abacus and gradually progress to learning how to add and subtract various digits or numbers on the abacus with the use of formulas, different formulas, small friend, big friend, etc. And by the time you finish Stage 1, you will have a good idea of which formula is used in which situation. Okay, so all addition and subtraction formulas will be covered by the time you finish Stage 1. Apart from this, I have included several practice sheets for practice of one digit number tables, which will help learners in Stage 2 when they will be learning to do basic multiplication on abacus. For most learners, the time duration required to finish Stage 1 will be around 8 weeks. For learners who are just about 6 or 7 years old, parents might have to go a little slow in the first week or two, but then they will gradually pick up and should be able to do it in about 8 to 9 weeks. Older learners can maybe finish this in less than 8 weeks if they do more than the minimum recommended sums per day. For learners who are less than 10 years of age, a parent's active involvement is a must. For older learners, in most cases, they will be able to handle the learning and the practice part on their own. Parents will need to just monitor them or support them with some guidance or with some difficulties. That's all. I have included all the lesson videos and example videos which are necessary for Stage 1 in a special playlist in a proper sequence. Okay, I have shared that playlist link in the description below, or you'll find it in the playlist page of my YouTube channel as well. Before opening the workbook, a learner must get comfortable with identifying numbers on the abacus. So to understand this part, please watch the lesson 1 video on my YouTube channel or in the playlist that I had mentioned a little while ago. In that, you'll understand how to identify 1 digit, 2 digit or 3 digit numbers. So understand it well and then practice it for different numbers of up to 3 digits. Okay, once you get comfortable with it, then open the workbook. For the first 3 pages, there are simple addition and subtraction sums involving all digits from 1 to 9. Okay, there will be no formula required here. Whatever number is to be added or subtracted, you'll have the perfect number of beads available. Okay, so minimum sums recommended is 20 sums per day from each of these 3 pages. So in 4 days time, you'll be finishing all these 3 pages. Remember, it's very important to focus on maintaining 100% accuracy right from day 1 of practice. You cannot think that you will improve accuracy later on. Try and achieve 100% accuracy right from day 1. Then moving to page 4 and 5, it involves the concept of small friend addition. Okay, so for this, to understand this concept, please watch the lesson 2 video in the playlist. This will help you understand when to use the small friend formula and how to use it. Okay, minimum recommended sums per day practice is 40 sums a day, so that you'll finish page 4 and page 5 in 4 days time. Similarly, the next 2 pages, that is page 6 and 7, are for understanding the use of small friend subtraction formulas. For this, please watch the lesson 3 video in the playlist and maintain the same rate of practice, that is 40 sums per day. This should help you complete these 2 pages also in 4 days time. Then on page number 8, we come to one digit multiplication tables practice. Okay, so I'll give some important instruction here for all learners, irrespective of age, whether you are 6 year old or 16 year old or an adult. For all learners, this is an important instruction. While doing any one digit multiplied by one digit multiplication, the answer should always be read as a two digit answer. Okay, for example, if we do 5 multiplied by 6, the answer is 30. It's already a 2-digit, so nothing to worry. But if we do 5 multiplied by 1, the answer is just 5. But here for abacus practice, during abacus practice, we'll have to take it as a 2-digit answer. So 5 multiplied by 1, it will be read as 05. The answer will be read as 05. Similarly, 3 multiplied by 2 or 2 multiplied by 3, the answer will be read as 06. And it has to be written as 06. Prefixing a 0 to any digit does not change its value, but this 2-digit answer will become extremely important when we are doing basic multiplication on abacus in stage 2. So remember, all situations where we arrive at a 1-digit answer, for example 1 multiplied by 4, if we will read the answer as 04. 2 multiplied by 4, the answer will be 08. 3 multiplied by 3, the answer will be 09. Okay, so in all such situations, wherever we are getting a 1-digit answer, we will prefix a 0 and write the answer like that. Okay, 03 or 06 or 09, like that. It's very important to practice it during all these multiplication tables practice sheets. Moving to page number 9 and 10, these are for practice of big friend addition formulas. So to understand the concept, please watch lesson number 4 video in the playlist. And remember an important point here, that even though these pages are designed for practice of big friend addition formulas, you might have to use the small friend formulas in certain situations. Remember, the formulas that you have already learned might be required to be used in certain situations. And in situations where small friend is to be used, you cannot use the big friend formulas. I have explained this in more detail in the video, so please watch it carefully, understand it well, and then start with practice. So the minimum dose required recommended is 40 sums per day, so that you finish these two pages in 4 days time. Moving to page number 11 and 12, these are for revision practice of all formulas that you have learnt till now, that is small friend addition, small friend subtraction, and big friend addition. So all these three types of formulas you will get to practice in these revision pages. Here you are supposed to do a minimum of 40 sums per day, so to finish these two pages in another 4 days time. Again, page number 13 is for tables practice, as I have already detailed in the previous slide. After completing big friend addition, page number 14 and 15 are for practice of big friend subtraction formulas. This concept has been explained in lesson 5 video in the playlist. So do watch this, and again the same number of sums are recommended to be done per day. Page number 16 and 17 are for revision sums, revision of all formulas that have been learned till now, that is small friend as well as big friend, addition as well as subtraction. Again, 40 sums per day is the minimum recommended. Remember, as a learner, you can do more than this minimum recommended sums, but please ensure that you do a minimum of 40 sums per day. Page number 18 is again tables practice. I have already detailed it before. Next, page number 19, it's an important note on use of combination formulas. Okay, so there are certain situations where you are trying to use the big friend formula, but you cannot use it in a smooth way. So in such situations, you need to use the combination formulas. I have explained the use of combination formulas in lesson 6 for combination addition formulas and lesson 7 for combination subtraction formulas. Do watch them properly, and the several example videos that I have included in the playlist, all those videos will also help you better understand the use of combination formulas. Okay, so before moving to the next page, please do watch these videos very carefully, understand it well, and then open page number 20. page 20 onwards, I have included alternate pages for addition practice and subtraction practice. Okay, so these pages are actually meant to give you good amount of practice of use of all different formulas in all possible situations. While doing these sums, please remember that you should try and achieve 100% accuracy. That is, you should achieve, you should be able to use the correct formula in each particular situation. This habit of doing it correctly is very important as you progress to higher stages of the course. And minimum recommended sums again here will be around 20 to 25 sums of addition and 20 to 25 sums of subtraction per day. Okay, so around 40 to 50 sums per day is the minimum recommended practice for these type of sums, along with the multiplication practice that I already spoken about, the tables practice. Okay, now please pause the video and carefully read the final point I mentioned on the slide in front of you. Okay. Finally, best wishes for your Abacus practice. And in case you face any difficulties that my videos haven't resolved, okay, then please write to me at the mentioned email address. I will try and explain it to you separately, or if it will be useful to everyone, I'll create a video for it and put it on my channel so that everyone can benefit from it.